Hey everybody, Varun here from Language Academy, and I've got Nandita with me, who is from Nepal, and she has smashed her PTE exam. She has got an overall 90 score, and she has got 90 in 3 sections and 85 in 1, which is a great score. Congratulations, Nandita.
Thank you
well
so
done.
Much. Thank you.
Such a great achievement. I know there was a moment when you were literally frustrated and you felt like giving up on PTE, and now you have smashed it. You've got 3 90s and 185. We'll start off with writing. Writing was one of the sections you were struggling a lot, and you thought that now I can't make it in writing. And now you have got 85 in writing. How's that? What did you change?
So with writing, every time I used to miss by 1 or 2 marks or 3 marks, I always kept on practicing essays and doing my summarized written text. I actually didn't even focus a lot on, you know, the section in listening that
Yeah, that's right.
And I always used to go back and just practice my essay every time. But then I feel like, you know, when you guided me, when you told me, you know, what areas of PTE can be masked for writing. So then I went back and I practiced a lot of reading and writing section from PTE reading. And also for writing, you have to be conscious about write from dictation, from listening
that's
as
right.
well, the carries marks, and also from filling the blanks from listening.
That's right.
So
that's
I think
right.
that's what helped me. I just went back and practiced it, you know, in different areas.
So you were not really aware that why you're not really getting points in your writing section. And yes, guys, it's very important to know that what mistake you are making, because you might not be getting points in your writing section, but that's not the reason. The writing section may not be the reason. The reason may be listening or your reading section. And how about listening? Listening is 90, perfect score. A lot of people out there, they're literally struggling in listening because they think that PTE has made listening very hard nowadays, but you have got 90 in listening. How's that?
With listening, I feel like I actually didn't really have a lot of issues with that. With listening, my strategy was just, I used to concentrate a lot on, you know, I used to concentrate when I used to get a, you know, reach a listening section. You have to listen really carefully to what the audio says as well. And write from dictation is also one of the most important section in listening. Like, you have to smash it to get, you know, the perfect score.
That's
and
right.
it's all about concentration in listening, I think, you know.
And what about the reading section? Again, 90, perfect. Reading is also one of the section, you know, a lot of students out there are struggling, and you were struggling as well. And now this time you have got 90, straight over 90. How's that?
With reading, I actually didn't know like where I was losing marks at all. Didn't know at all. Like, I felt maybe I was missing out on multiple choice, multiple, you know, answers. I thought maybe I was missing out on reorder paragraphs. But then when I met you and when you told me probably you are missing out on this section, it was reading and writing and filling the blanks. And then I thought, I went back and I actually, you know, thought back to, you know, how I was doing. I went back to my results, and then, you know, I practiced a lot. I really did practice a lot this time. And then, yeah, I don't know, it happened. I wasn't expecting 90 though.
And how about MCQ multiple answer? How many options did you select over there?
I only selected one.
Yeah, she selected only one option in MCQ multiple answers in reading, and she has got 90 perfect in reading. And that is one of the tricks you all can use in reading as well. And at last, how did the mock exam help you? You know, you did a lot of mock tests before that. How did they help you?
With mock tests, what it helped me was, you know, when you sit on that examination table, you tend to be nervous, panic a lot. But when you do mock exam beforehand, you're more confident because it feels exactly like an exam. It's a 3-hour time frame. And then because of mock exam as well, I was so confident. I wasn't nervous at all when I did my exam.
That's right, guys. That's right. So, you know, going through the exam pattern before you go for the actual exam, it's very important. You are used to the exam. You know that what's going to be next, what's going to be after this, and how you have to approach that task. And a lot of power and positivity to all the PTE aspirants out there who are preparing for the exam. More power to you guys. Go and smash the exam, prepare properly, and you will do it for sure. Thanks, guys. That's it from this video. I'll see you very soon in the next video. Thank you, guys.
Good luck.